So hello everyone, welcome back to my presentation of Ultimate COVID-19 Solution. Introduction of my project. COVID-19 is spreading extremely fast in the whole world. There are a total of 211 countries being affected by the deadly virus as per worldometers.info. Thus, during this extreme scenario, it's of an immense need to control the cases worldwide. There has been many different protocols used by the government to do so, of which extreme lockdowns and maintaining social distancing is of the utmost importance. Therefore, due to this sudden protocols being practiced out by the government, the increased rate of coronavirus cases worldwide is being lowered down than it was earlier. Now what is the need of my project? Due to contamination of the virus, many doctors are being affected. As of 9th April, more than 100 Italian doctors have died because of contamination from coronavirus. Thus, making smart devices using our extremely developed technology is more essential. Moreover, it will be a boon for healthcare workers and doctors working round the clock during this pandemic period. Our whole world is thankful to these doctors, and now it's our turn to protect themselves by saving ourselves. What my project actually is. My project consists of a health band along with an app named as Corona Secure. It is made up of a small Arduino Nano, an ESP8266 Wi-Fi module, MAX 30100 pulse oximeter sensor, and a 10K NTG thermistor. I have also developed an app as discussed earlier named as Corona Secure using MIT App Inventor 2 and a smart assistant using IEEE. The entire device is so reduced to the size that it can easily fit as a watch on our hands. Here is a rough schematic or the rough diagram of how the placement of the devices should be placed. How does my project actually work? We will put the device in a person's hand and the Arduino Nano will take up data from the MAX 30100 sensor and the thermistor. The device needs to be attached to the body using a wrist strap, that is a Velcro. Then the thermistor needs to be placed below our arm and the MAX 30100 sensor will be placed under the device as because the device will have some weight and that pressure will be applied on the sensor. Thus the sensor will receive the data more precisely. Here you can see a rough image diagram of how this project should be placed or how the device should be used. Our device is based on Wi-Fi technology as discussed earlier, that is all the amount of data received by the Arduino will be transferred to our Corona Secure app using the ESP01 or the ESP8266 Wi-Fi module. The app will survey the person for 2 weeks, which is a normal quarantine period as per WHO, and if any possible chances of the person being affected by coronavirus, then it will be informed to the local police and hospital services using the GPS system already present in our mobiles. I have also added a VoIP call feature using IEEE as already discussed earlier to the registered mobile number. Every day, after a certain time, IEEE assistant will call to the registered mobile number requesting the patient to fill up the survey form regularly. Here is a brief chain of how the project will work. Step 1. Taking data from MAX 30100 sensor and the NTC thermistor. Step 2. Data being sent to the Arduino Nano for retrieval. Step 3. The device is getting connected to our mobile using ESP8266 Wi-Fi module. After successful connection, the patient fills up a survey form. Step 5. Then this entire data is being uploaded to the cloud service. Step 6. If any chances of the COVID-19 occurs, then this data is being sent to the local doctors along with the GPS location of the patient. The functioning of the MAX 30100 sensor. The main reason of the usage of MAX 30100 sensor is that it operates at a very low voltage from 1.8 volt up to 3.3 volt power supplies and it can be easily powered through a negligible standby current. It also takes up the data in the two forms, that is, it can take up the pulse oximetry, pulse sensing data, as well at the same time it can also take the oxygen level present in our blood. Here you can see that there is a given rough diagram on the basis of which the low concentration and the high concentration the MAX 30100 sensor works and gives the data to the Arduino Nano. NTC thermistors. The main usage of NTC thermistors is mainly because it is, first of all, it is very cheap in cost. It costs around 10 to 15 rupees like that, and also at the same time it can be measured or it can be used even through direct current. and also at the same time it is very widely used nowadays for temperature measuring of human body. The features of my device, or why should we use this device? No contact or any risk of contamination with the healthcare workers or even the doctors with the infected patients, which is the feature number one. Patients can be treated from their home only, thus no need of going to the hospital for frequent checkups. Third, continuous surveillance of patients leads to proper distinguishing of the contamination and they can be treated very easily. Four, extremely cheap device under $10, thus it can be used by people of any economic level and can be used very effectively. That's it. Thank you for listening to my presentation.